Learn about creating a container image with Docker in this edition of Azure Tips and Tricks. In the last video, we saw how we could pull down a Docker container and create an ASP.NET application that runs inside of it. In this one, we're going to take it even further and create our own image that runs the application. So first thing that we're going to do is let's go back into our container. The last time we called it my app, and we created a folder called my app inside of it. And inside of this folder, you can see that we have our ASP.NET application. Now, what I want to do is create a script that's going to execute this for us. Let's go over to /user/local/bin. Now we're going to create a startup file. So we're going to call this startmyapp.sh. We're going to put in the /bin/sh. Next, on the next line, we're going to do .NET run -p. And now we're going to give it the path to our project. So that's going to be myapp.csproj. That should be it. I'm going to hit Control D to exit. If I just type this out really quick, let's just make sure that our script looks like what we expect it to look like. Okay, great. Now inside of the container, let's just go ahead and make sure that this is executable. Great. So it prints out hello world as we expect it to. So let's clear that. I'm going to exit the container. And now in Docker, I'm going to type docker ps -a. Now this should show me all the containers that I had previously running on my machine. What I need to do now is I need to commit the changes that we just made to that Docker container. The tag for this one happens to start with 824. Now I could go ahead and type in the rest of the container ID, but I actually only need just enough of the characters for Docker to recognize it. Next, now I'm going to give my container a name. I'm going to call it Cecil Philip Awesome App. All right, great. So now if I type Docker images, we should see we have Cecil Philip Awesome App. And that's the container that we just created. Now let's execute the image that we just created. I'm going to type docker run Cecil Philip colon awesome app. So that's the name of the image that we just created. And startmyapp.sh, which is the bash script that we wrote. So if I execute this, I should see hello world as expected printed out to the console. And that's how we can create a container image using Docker by appending on to an already existing container.